both of these 100 degree thorn experiments have seem to have been proving negative so far, even after a couple of days. Not a single microscopic bubble has come off of these things, so as such, as you do, I'm coming in here, going back into my rapidly diminishing charcoal in here to take out some of the choicer bits and just fill up this container just like the other one, just fill it up as much as I can to the level, and I'm going to fill it up with hot water, you know, boiling hot water, you know, 98, 99 degrees straight off the boil, and then I'm going to let it cool down, and as soon as it's cool it goes in the freezer. It may have to go in the deep freezer, I don't know whether I can actually fit this in the normal freezer. I would like to put it in the same freezer as the little cans, because that's more scientific, to put it in the same thing you've done before. But you can always run another experiment in the deep freezer. Whether the colder, you know, the 17, 19 of the deep freeze will make a difference between the, is it 11 and 13 degrees of the normal fridge? I can't remember, I'd have to look up my my old experiments from years ago when I did actually measure the temperature in the diurnal wobble sort of thing. But it's very interesting because apparently according to Robertson Oostings, the Dionaea does not occur, snow only occurs outside the Dionaea regional zone, sort of thing. So, which is very interesting, which means it basically probably doesn't get cold enough to freeze water. So if you have some sort of bushfire over there, and then you get some rain, and it always rains the most. I think they get most of their rain in the summer. So if you have a bushfire in the summer, followed by some more rain in the summer after the bushfire, the charcoal gets wet, and then you go through there one of the winters where does it get cold enough to freeze it or not? That's the question. If it doesn't, then you get the. I assume you will get the. Reductive flammable gas being generated, sort of thing. However, if it freezes, maybe not, you see. And does the fire get hot enough to, you know, I don't know. Do you have to have the water straight away on the charcoal, you know? I mean, you know, so you've got hot charcoal followed by summer rains, I don't know, you know? I don't know. Anyway, these are questions we can probably slowly begin to tear apart and work out. But anyway, this is what I'm going to do. So the next video clip is probably going to be me putting, you've seen me put hot water in again. You don't really want to see that again, but you probably do want to see it being put into the freezer. I think I'm going to just have to do the whole thing for completeness, of course. Otherwise people just won't believe you. Anyway, over and out for now.